Okay, good evening, my dear students. Welcome to GradeUp, India's biggest e-learning platform. So I welcome you all to this live session of the kinematic analysis of single slider crack mechanism. Okay, so very good evening, guys. I want a response from you guys whether I am audible and video is clear or not. Please respond quickly so that I get to know that you are able to hear me and you are able to see me. Good evening, guys. Okay, so in today's session, we'll be talking about the kinematic analysis of single slider crank mechanism. Very good evening, Ajay Singh. Pranam. Okay, so like in the yesterday's session, we have talked about the gear trains. We have divided the two segments, like we have discussed about the four different classification of gear trains. Okay, and we have discussed, we have solved some problems also in the yesterday's session. In today's session, we'll be talking about the kinematic analysis of single slider crank mechanism. Okay, fine. Before starting the session, I would like to share a thought from the WHO, which they have provided, how to wash your hands in order to protect yourself and against infections. Okay, very good evening, Anirban Mishra. Very good evening. So I'll be telling you about the 12 steps, how to wash your hands, because this is very important. As you all know, we all are fighting against the corona or COVID-19. So it's better you need to be stay hygienic and clean. And this is the 12 steps, how to wash your hands. So first of all, you need to wet your hands. In second step is you need to apply the soaps, rub hands palm to palm, lather the back of your hands. Scrub between your fingers, rub the backs of the fingers on the opposing palms, clean thumbs, wash fingernails, fingertips, rinse hands, dry with a single towel. Okay, so these are the 12 steps how you need to wash your hands, because you all know there is a 21 days lockdown going on. 21 days lockdown. So you need to be stay at your home. Fine. So you need to stay at your home, because the only option to fight for this COVID-19 is just stay at your home, be hygienic, clean yourself regularly. Okay, good evening, Neeraj, Kushal, Anirvan, and Ajay. And if you are finding anyone else, like if you're near ones, or if you're having any doubt or guidance required for or support or technical queries, Government of India has given you a toll-free number. This is +91 11 23 97 8046. If this is a control room number which is given by Government of India for any guidance, support or technical queries which you are having. Okay, good evening, Neeraj, Chanchal. So how are you guys? I hope all of you are healthy, safe, and having we can say healthy environment. Okay, you too, Anirban Mishra, you too are safe, because I want everyone to be safe. Just we need to fight against this virus, COVID-19, and the only option is stay at your home, stay safe. That's it. Okay, now today's topic, before starting today's topic, let us introduce myself. Sir, fluid mechanics mein bahut problem ho rahi hai, kaun si book prefer karni chahiye? Fluid mechanics mein you need to prefer, like DS Kumar is a very good book, Modi and Sid is also very good book. You can go for either one of them. Okay, now let me introduce myself. My name is Suraj Gopi. I have 5+ of year experience. I have master's in thermal science and engineering. I have mentored 5,000+ aspirants, GATE, ESC, and SSC JEE. My area of expertise is mechanics, thermal science, heat transfer, industrial engineering, and theory of machine. Okay, so this is my area of expertise. I usually take these subjects for ESC and GATE aspirants, or also for SSC JEE. Okay, now let us start today's topic of the kinematic analysis of single slider crank mechanism. Now, we have understood in the first topic, in the first simple mechanism, we have understood the single slider crank mechanism in detail. Now, what do you mean by kinematic analysis? I want you guys to tell me what is the meaning of this term, kinematic analysis. Yes. What do you mean by this term? What do you mean by, what is the difference between kinematic and dynamic analysis? Because the tomorrow session or the day after tomorrow session will be having the dynamic analysis of single slider crank mechanism. So today's session will be talking about the kinematic analysis. It's a very, very basic and easy topic. Okay, don't worry, I'll be taking each and every parameter which is there in this single slider kinematic analysis we'll be discussing in detail. Sir, exam pressure bahut rehta hai mujhe. I am studying a lot, still I'm not able to solve any question in exam. Ankur, for this I want to suggest you need to practice, you need to solve some mock problems now, because as you are saying that you are completing the all syllabus but you are not able to perform well in the examination, what you need to do is you need to solve some problem. Fine, you need to attempt mock test. You need to attempt mock test because mock will be giving you a basic idea where you are standing. Exactly, Ronak Sajjan and Ramesh Mohan, both of you are correct. So in this case we are not considering any forces, that means no forces, we are not considering any forces, not considering any forces. Okay, not considering any forces. So this analysis is known as kinematic analysis, and in the next session we'll be discussing about the dynamic analysis where we'll be considering the different forces. Okay. And Ankur, please don't worry, just you need to practice problems, because if you have completed the syllabus, only thing is you do is practice problems, attempt some mock papers, come live to the mock test, because we are having n number of mock tests going on all the platform. So you can definitely reach out to that platform where all India level examination is going on. So definitely you need to see where you are standing. Okay. Okay, so now today's session we'll be talking about the kinematic analysis. Kinematic analysis, we won't be considering any forces. So this is known as the kinematic analysis. Now let us have a brief discussion about this single slider gang mechanism. Now this is basically known as a piston or a slider, also known as, this is known as piston or slider. This is your crank. This is basically the crank. This is your connecting rod. This is your connecting rod. This is your crank. Okay, so crank is basically what is happening. We are having a rotational motion converting into a reciprocating motion. Okay, or reciprocating motion converting into a rotational motion. Okay, so in case of a single slider crank mechanism, we are having a reciprocating, that means this reciprocating motion into a rotational motion. That is your IC engine. You might have studied. Okay, now if I talk about the two extreme points, we are having B1 and B. These are the two extreme points of the slider. Now what is the meaning of the extreme points? Anyone who can tell me what is the meaning of these extreme points? In a single slider crank mechanism, there are two extreme points. One is B1 and B. So this is basically your inner dead center and this is your outer dead center. Okay, this is an inner dead center and outer dead center, also known as bottom dead center and the top dead center, which is basically we are using this terminology in the vertical engine. As this is a horizontal engine, we are basically using inner dead center. This is your IDC, inner dead center, and this is your, this point where B is, this is your outer dead center. Okay. IDC and ODC. Very good, Vishnu. Now, if I say, can you tell me what will be the stroke length of this slider, of this mechanism? Can anyone tell me what will be the stroke length? What will be the stroke length? Just tell me in terms of ABCD. Just tell me in terms of ABCD, what will be the stroke length? Will it be AB or BC or BB1 or BM? Just tell me. Exactly. Fine. So these two are IDC and ODC are the two extreme ends of the slider. Clear? Exactly. Very good. So stroke length, I can say directly your stroke length or displacement. Instead of stroke length, I can also use as the term as displacement of piston. Displacement of piston can be equal to B1B. This will be the displacement of the piston. Exactly, it can be the twice radius of crank also. Don't it's only the same thing. This is also equal to twice the radius of the crank, because if we are having a position at A1, let us suppose the crank is at the position at A1, then your piston will be at this location, which is your IDC. Okay, if it is at this location, so it will be having at the bottom dead center. Twice of the radius of crank or the diameter of the crank, or in this figure, your X is basically representing the stroke length. The X is basically representing the stroke length. Okay. Vivek Reddy is correct. Chanchal, Kathal, Vishnu, Abhishek, Umar. Very good. Very good. Twice of OA. Also correct. Very good. Diameter of the crank, all if you are correct. So now you have understood what are the different parameters, what are the different nomenclatures which we are discussing. Now there is one angle which you need to understand. There is an angle which crank is making. This angle is theta, and the connecting rod, the angle made by the connecting rod with the line of stroke. Now what is this line? This is the line of stroke, because along this only your stroke and we are measuring, along this only your sliding is happening. So this is the line of stroke. Okay, this line is the line of stroke. So along the line of stroke, the angle between the line of stroke and the connecting rod is beta, and the line of stroke and your crank is theta. Okay, and L is the length of the connecting rod, and R is the radius of crank. So these are the different terminologies which I'll be using again and again. So in the first diagram itself, I have explained you in detail what are the different terminologies which we are seeing. Okay, clear? Now, let us understand this in detail. Now, let us suppose the mass of the reciprocating part. What is reciprocating part in this case? It is basically the piston. The mass of the piston, I am taking it as M. The crank radius is R. Length of the connecting rod is L. Now, there is a term which is known as obliquity ratio. Okay, which you are using while solving, while having a derivation understanding. Obliquity ratio is the ratio of length of the connecting rod to the radius of the crank. It is L by R ratio. Okay, omega is the angular velocity of the crank. Theta is the angle turned by the crank by from IDC or TDC, one of the same thing. And omega is, what is omega? Omega is the angular velocity of crank. This is omega, and omega is the angular velocity of the crank. Okay, so in this L by R, yes. Now in this kinematic analysis, what we'll be studying is, we'll be calculating three basic parameters. Okay, we'll be calculating three basic parameters. That is your displacement of piston, displacement of piston denoted as X, also known as stroke length. Also known as stroke length. Second is velocity of piston. Velocity of piston, and third is acceleration of piston. Okay, so these three terms, because obviously piston won't be having any rotational motion, it will be having a displacement, or it will be having a translation motion. Thank you, Joseph. Thank you. Thank you for that comment. Okay, so these three things will be understanding in detail in this kinematic analysis. Clear? Now, let us understand the first thing, that is the displacement of the piston. Displacement of the piston denoted as X. Okay, now in this diagram, X, what is X? This is the displacement of the piston. We have just now understood. So I can directly write X is equal to B1 into B. X is equal to B1B, the length B1B. Okay, if this is length B1B, now I can write B1B as, I can write B1B as B1O minus BO. You can see in the diagram, I can write this as B1O minus BO. That will be given as B1B. So same thing, B1O minus BO. Now what is B1O? What is B1O? This is the extreme position. Now, if I draw this diagram, this is your B1, this is your B. Okay, so when the piston is at the extreme position, what is happening? Your angle is basically zero. This will be your crank. This will be your crank. Okay, this will be your crank, and this will be your connecting rod. This will be your connecting rod. Okay, fine. So in that case, this is L, this is R, this is point O. So B1O will be, this will be your total length, L plus R or R plus L. And your BO will be, I can write BO, BO as L cos theta, L cos beta plus R cos theta, L cos beta plus R cos theta. It's one of the same, very easy thing. This only pure trigonometry we are using. Okay. Now, I can use this. If you take this triangle, triangle, let me remove this. Let us take triangle AMB and triangle AMO and triangle AMO. Okay, let us take this triangle. Now, I can equate AM. AM is a common length. AM is a common length. So, I can directly write it is equal to L sine beta is equal to R sine theta. Okay, or I can write sine theta, sine beta is equal to sine theta by n. What is n? N is equal to L by R obliquity ratio, just now I have told you. Okay, so I can write sine beta is equal to sine theta by n. The same thing. instead of sine beta, I can write sine theta by n. So what will be cos beta? If sine beta is equal to sine theta by n, what will be cos beta? Cos beta will be equal to 1 minus sine square theta upon n square under root. Okay, so I'm placing this value of cos beta over here in this equation. I'm getting this formula. Okay, I'm getting this formula. Fine, very basic. Now, when you take n square in the numerator, this n will be common, so this will be cancelling out. So this n and this n will be cancelling out. So ultimately, we are having a equation which is x is equal to r into 1 minus cos theta plus r 1 minus n square sine square theta. Fine, take r common. So this is the formula. Now, if I compare the value of n, n is basically much, much greater than the value of sine theta. Okay. Fine. So n is basically much, much greater than the value of sine theta. So I can directly write, we can neglect this, we can directly take this as is equal to n square. This is n square under root. So ultimately your x value is equal to r into 1 minus cos theta. Okay. So this is your displacement formula of the piston. Whenever, if you want to calculate what is the displacement made by the piston at any angle theta. Fine. So you can calculate the value of displacement. That means if theta is equal to, let us suppose if theta is equal to 90 degree, if theta equal to 90 degree, then what would be the x value? Please tell me quickly. If theta is equal to 90 degree, then what will be the value of x? It will be definitely equal to R. That means the displacement made by from the inner dead center will be equal to R. The same thing. That means when the piston is at this location, that is perpendicular location, in that case, the displacement will be exactly equal to R. Okay. Fine. So this formula is very important because sometimes they are asking objective type problem from this topic. That is, what is the displacement made by the piston if it is having a movement of theta? Okay, fine. Is that clear? So if I say theta is equal to zero, tell me what will be the displacement? What will be the approximate displacement? If theta is equal to 0, then what will be displacement? Now, what is the formula we are having? X is equal to R into 1 minus cos theta. This is the formula we are having. If theta is equal to 0, then the displacement will be definitely will be equal to 0, because at that position it's lagging. Okay, now it's also lagging. Let me check, guys. It's correct now. Okay, so if x theta is equal to 0, definitely your x value will be equal to 0, because that position, can you tell me what will be the position? What will be the position of the piston? It will be at the inner dead center. It will be at the inner dead center. Okay, it will be at the inner dead center. Very good, all of you. Vivek, Sharachandran, Shashi, Gaurav, Vishnu, all of you are correct. So if I say theta is equal to, let us suppose theta is equal to 180 degree. Tell me, if theta equal to 180 degree, then what is the value of x? What is the value of displacement? Theta equal to 180 degree means cos theta 180 is minus 1. That will be 2r. That will be 2r. Okay. So this basically tells you about, you can calculate by using this expression, you can calculate the displacement at any angular position, at any angular position of crank. Okay. At any angular position of crank. Clear? So this formula is very important. Now let us we have understood derivations are important or not, because this kinematic derivations are, it's not the derivation, we cannot call this as a derivation, it's a concept. Okay. Because these are not derivations, this is the concept, because from where this, because this is approximate value, this is approximate value of displacement, because we have used a boundary condition. What is boundary condition? That n is greater than sine theta. That is the condition we are having. Okay, so this is not a derivation, it's just an understanding of kinematic analysis of single slider gang mechanism. Clear? Now let us talk about the velocity of piston. Now what will be the velocity of piston? Now let us suppose velocity denoted as v. So v will be equal to dx by dt. V will be equal to dx by dt. Very easy. Now in our case, what is the value of x we are having? We are having the value of x as x is equal to r into 1 minus cos theta plus n minus under root n square minus sine square theta. Now but in our case, the x is a function of time. How to convert this in terms of theta? What we'll be doing, we'll be having dx by d theta. Dx by d theta into d theta by dt. We can write this expression as dx by d theta into d theta by dt. What is d theta by dt? It is omega. So I can write this as dx by d theta into omega. Now I can differentiate this expression. What is this expression? X is equal to r into 1 minus cos theta. Fine. 1 minus cos theta plus n plus n minus under root n square minus sine square theta, n square minus sine square theta. Okay, so I can differentiate this equation. Definitely I can differentiate. Now x is a function of, because in this case x is a function of theta, and I can differentiate this expression over here. So we'll be getting, after differentiating, it will be approximately omega into sine theta plus sine 2 theta upon 2 into under root of n square minus sine square theta. Okay, after differentiating, I'm getting this expression. Now again I'm using a boundary condition, n is greater than sine theta, so this will be omega into sine theta plus sine 2 theta by 2n. Okay, now this gives you the expression of the velocity of the piston at any angular position of the crank. Clear? So if I want to write velocity is equal to omega, and r is also there, please make sure r is also there, omega into r into sine theta plus sine 2 theta by 2n. Yes, exactly. Vivek is correct. In general view, v is equal to r omega. Yes, it is equal to r omega, but it is an average value. We are not calculating at particular angular, at particular theta. R, we have, I've taken the r value. Okay. So, v is equal to omega into r into sine theta plus sine 2 theta by 2n. Sine 2 theta by 2n. Is that clear? So, in this case, I can calculate this velocity of the crank at any angular position, at any angular position of crank. Okay, so I can calculate the velocity of this piston at any angular velocity, at any angular position of the crank, that is, which is, what is the angular position of the crank, which is equal to theta. Okay, so if I calculate what is the velocity at theta, at theta is equal to 0 degree, please tell me quickly what will be the velocity at theta equal to 0. What is theta equal to 0? That means we are talking about at inner dead center condition, IDC. We are talking about IDC position. We are talking about IDC position. Tell me what will be the velocity at theta equal to 0 degree. It will be equal to, at theta equal to 0 degree, your velocity will be equal to 0. Your velocity will be equal to 0. Is that clear? Okay, now why it is equal to 0, please, can anyone who can tell me why the velocity is equal to 0 at IDC? Why the velocity is equal to 0 at IDC? Now, if I draw this diagram over here, let me draw the diagram over here. So, we are having a slider. We are having a slider. This is a connecting rod. This is a crank. Okay, this is a line stroke. So, theta, this is your angle theta. Fine. So, this will be your IDC, inner dead center. So, at this location, that is the extreme location, your velocity is equal to 0. Why velocity equal to 0? Because your direction is changing. Your direction is changing. Remember, your direction is changing. Direction is changing. That is why. Okay, direction is changing. Or we can say it just started moving. Or if you want to say after the complete cycle, when it comes to the initial position, that is the theta equal to 0. That means the direction is changing. If the direction is changing, definitely the linear velocity will be equal to 0. Is that clear? Exactly. It is coming to rest, then again it is changing the direction and moving back. Clear? Okay. Same thing is happening if theta is equal to 180 degree. If theta equal to 180 degree, that means we are talking about the outer dead center. That means your crank is located somewhere around here. This is your crank. Okay. And this is the location of your outer dead center. Same thing, velocity will be equal to 0. Why velocity equal to 0? Again, the same reason, the direction is changing. The direction is changing, that means you are having the extreme ends of the slider. Clear? Understood? This is very important. And I'm trying to visualize you guys. Let me use another color so that I can explain you one more time with some another color. Yes. Now, let us suppose this is your theta equal to 180 degree. This is your crank. This is your crank. Okay. So, theta equal to 180 degree. That means this is the position. This is the position when theta equal to 180 degree. Okay. So, in that case, theta equal to 180 degree. This is your crank. So, this will be your position of the slider will be at this location, which is the outer dead center. Okay. Fine. Understood. So, this expression, which is omega r into sine theta plus sine 2 theta by 2n, is very important, which is gives you the velocity of the slider. Clear? Now let us talk about the third component, the third parameter, which is known as the acceleration of the piston. Now again, the same approach, we'll be using the same approach. Acceleration is equal to dv by dt. Okay, dv by dt, acceleration is equal to dv by dt. Now again, velocity, what is velocity? It is equal to omega r sine theta plus sine 2 theta by n, by 2n. So expression, so we'll be again converting in the form of theta dv by d theta into d theta by dt. Now we'll be having this expression, that means we'll be differentiating the v with respect to theta. So we'll be having the expression, a very, very famous expression. And believe it or not, we'll be using this expression again and again. Okay. So this will be omega r square, omega r square into cos theta plus cos 2 theta by n. Okay. We'll be using this equation again and again in almost like balancing also. We'll be using this equation. Okay. We'll be having the explanation of the primary balancing, secondary balancing, everything we'll be discussing. So this is very, very important. Please try to visualize this. So acceleration of the slider or acceleration of the piston will be equal to omega into r square. Okay. No, sorry, this will be omega square into r, not omega r square. It will be omega in omega square into r into cos theta cos 2 theta by n. That means acceleration, that means if I again write it, acceleration is equal to r omega square cos theta plus cos 2 theta by n. Okay, cos 2 theta by n. So this is the formula of the acceleration of the piston. Clear? Very, very important, because this expression is very useful in many of the applications. How r square came? No, it's not r square, it's omega square. It's a change in over here, because what is d omega by dt? This is equal to omega. D theta by dt is omega. So already an omega is there. So omega square r. It is omega square r, it's not r square. Please change this. Let me rub this. Okay. So this is omega square r into cos theta plus cos 2 theta by n. Very, very important. Please make sure this is very, very important. Don't, if you're having any doubt, please tell me right now. I have taken up this topic in order to have an understanding, better understanding of the balancing, because the balancing base will be created under this topic only. Okay, clear? Karnataka, Bangalore, Vivek, Pavan, Sharan Chandran, Sai, Shashi. So I suppose now it's clear. Okay, so these three expression, if I summarize the three expression, that means x is equal to r into 1 minus cos theta, this is the displacement, velocity is equal to r omega into sine theta plus sine 2 theta by 2n, 2 theta by 2n, and acceleration is equal to r omega square into cos theta plus cos 2 theta by n. Cos 2 theta by n. Clear? Fine. So this expression is very important for solving a problem whenever you are getting a problem from the single slider crank mechanism. Okay? Clear? Vivek Reddy. Now we have discussed about if I take back to the Bain diagram, we have discussed about everything about the piston. We have discussed about the x, the velocity and acceleration of the piston. Okay, so we have discussed all the three parameters of the piston. Now let us discuss about the connecting rod, because connecting rod will be having an angular motion. Piston is having only a translational motion. But if I talk about the connecting rod, it will be having an angular motion. So let us discuss about this one by one, what will be the angular motion of the connecting dot. Okay, fine. Are you able to understand this? Okay, now let us try to understand the analysis of connecting dot. Again, now at this point of time, you have understood the slider mechanism, what are the different types of movement is going on. So in the slider, we're having a displacement, we're having velocity, we're having the acceleration, because this is moving in a translation. Yes, we'll be having every classes will be there. Strength of material, we are also planning after this. Let us see which subject will be starting. Okay, fine. Analysis of connecting rod. The main agenda for this sessions are like you, because you all are staying at your home and you all might be sleeping or playing games. So just try to have 1 or 2 hours with grade up every day, because that will make your preparation up to date, because you need to be in touch with your subject, because after this coronavirus, after this COVID-19 will be ended, again we'll be having a bunch of examinations. NLC will be there, we'll be having your WISEC will be there, your SSCJ will be there. So don't worry, it's only thing you need to be in touch with the subject. Okay, now let us talk about the analysis of connecting rod. The connecting rod will be having an angular velocity. Why it will be having angular velocity? Because it will be having a rotational moment. If you see this diagram, if this is the connecting rod, this is the crank. Okay, so we'll definitely be having a moment like this. So let us suppose the beta is the angular displacement of the connecting rod. What is beta? This angle is beta. This angle is beta. That means the angle made by the connecting rod with the line of stroke. Fine. So let me draw a very clear diagram. So this is your connecting rod, this is the crankshaft, this is your connecting rod, this is your crank. Okay, so this angle is beta, this angle is beta. Okay, and this angle is theta. So don't be confused, the L is L, the radius is R. Let us suppose this is B, this is A, this is M, this is O. Okay, same thing. I'm just drawing for you guys. Now, angular displacement of the connecting rod. What will be the angular displacement of the connecting rod? The beta is the angular displacement of the connecting rod, which will be given in the problem. Okay, which will be given in the problem. So, what is the angular velocity of the connecting rod? What will be the angular velocity of the connecting rod? Angular velocity of the connecting rod will be d beta by dt. Are you able to get it? The rate of change of angle will be giving you the angular velocity. So angular velocity of the connecting rod will be d beta by dt. Now, what is sine theta? Sine beta. Just now we have seen in the previous derivation, sine beta is equal to sine theta by n. Okay. Now, if you differentiate both the side, then we'll be having, let me check it. Okay. If you differentiate both the side, then in that case, we'll be having cos beta. Cos beta into d beta by dt is equal to cos theta by n into d theta by dt. What is d theta by dt? This is equal to omega. Okay, so I can write d beta by dt is equal to omega cos theta by n cos beta. Now what is cos beta? What is cos beta? Cos beta is equal to, we have seen in the previous case, under root of 1 minus sine theta, sine square theta upon n square. Just place this value. When you place this value in this equation, let us suppose this is equation 1. Okay, so you'll be getting d beta is equal to, you'll be getting d beta by dt is equal to omega cos theta upon under root of n square minus sine square theta. Again, same approximation, n is very, very higher than that of sine theta, and it's very, very higher than that of sine theta. So in that case, your d beta by dt, your d beta by dt will be equal to omega cos theta by n. Very, very important expression, very, very important, my dear students. It is a very important expression. So this basically gives you the angular velocity of connecting rod at each and every angular position of crank. Very important. So this will give you the angular velocity of the connecting rod at each and every position of the crank. That means at theta equal to 0 degree, at theta equal to 180 degree, you will be getting the value of omega of the connecting rod. Is that clear? Understood? Please respond me if you are not able to understand. Please quickly tell me. So that is very important. Your understanding to this subject is very important. Clear? Vivek, Shravan, Yashwan, Kanadika. Okay. So can we move to the next topic of the connecting rod, because we have calculated the angular velocity of connecting rod. Next is we need to understand what is the angular acceleration of the connecting rod, because at this moment we know what is the angular velocity of the connecting rod. Next we'll be calculating what is the angular acceleration of the connecting rod. Okay, what is the angular acceleration of the connecting rod? Clear? Now what is angular acceleration? It is denoted by alpha. Alpha is equal to d omega cr by dt. D omega cr by dt, very, very basic thing. Vishnu, Sharachandran, Vivek, Benny, yes, very good. Thank you guys for your response. I can write this as Vivek Reddy. What is your problem? Okay, numerical. Okay, I will be taking a numerical after discussing the dynamic analysis. Okay, don't worry. After taking the dynamic only, I'll be in a position to ask some problem, because in this is very one liner problem. If I say what is the angular velocity of the connecting rod at theta equal to 0 degree, you can see, you can directly calculate by keeping the value of theta, because L and R value will be directly given in the problem. Okay, so we'll be having a discussion of the problems while we'll be discussing the dynamic analysis of the single strata, because in that case forces will also be coming and the problem will be exciting and very conceptual. Okay, now again coming back to this, what is omega? Omega cr connecting rod of this is omega cos theta by n. Fine. Again, I can write this as omega cr by d theta into d theta by dt. Okay, d theta by dt, same thing. So when you differentiate this expression with the your theta, this is your d theta. Fine. So you'll be having omega minus sine theta upon n. This is omega. Okay, so you're having, this is equal to minus omega square sine theta by n. Okay, so this gives you the angular acceleration of the connecting rod, that is minus omega square sine theta by n. Now there is a negative sign in this. What is the significance of this negative sign? Anyone who can tell me what is the significance of this negative sign? What is the significance of this negative sign? Please quickly tell me. Now, whenever if there is an angular acceleration, if you're having a negative sign, you might have studied in the mechanics topic. Okay, if you're having a negative acceleration, what is the nomenclature for that? What is the name which we are giving for the negative acceleration? Yes. What is the name which we are giving for the negative acceleration? Please tell me quickly. It will be equal to Exactly, very good, very good. I want you to be please active. What is a negative sign of acceleration called? It is called a retardation. Okay, it is called retardation. Clear? It is called retardation. So, what's the meaning of this? So, we are having whenever the connecting rod is having an angular acceleration, it will always be having a retardation case. Clear? Why retardation case? Because we'll be having some opposite force. We'll be talking about that force in the next session in the dynamic analysis. Okay, fine. Is that clear? Deacceleration or retardation is the same thing. Sharan Chandra is absolutely correct. Either retardation or deacceleration is one of the same thing. Okay, clear? Fine. So this completes your kinematic analysis of single slider crank mechanism. Now let me ask you some problems, ask you some questions so that I can see whether you have understood or not. Can anyone tell me at IDC, at IDC, that means at inner dead center, tell me what will be the displacement of the piston? What will be displacement of the piston? Yes. What will be the x value of the piston? Quickly tell me, and those telling me, I'll be very happy. Tell me the displacement of the piston, velocity of the piston, and acceleration of the piston quickly. And also, you have to tell me what is the omega of connecting rod? Connecting rod omega value, omega of connecting rod, and alpha of connecting rod at IDC. I'm talking about ID quickly. Very good. X is equal to 0. Very good. So now you have understood how to calculate the displacement, velocity, and acceleration. Very good. All of you are very good. Just we need to write X is equal to 0, V equal to which, because 0 can be for V also, A also. You need to tell me X equal to 0, V equal to 0, A equal to 0, or any other case. Fine. So I'll be writing the expression for you guys. X is equal to R into 1 minus cos theta. Velocity is equal to omega r into sine theta. Yes, v equal to. Yes, Vivek, tell me what will be the value of v. I'm writing the expression for you guys, sine 2 theta by n. And acceleration is equal to. Very good, Vivek. Omega square r cos theta plus cos 2 theta by n. There is 2. Yes, quickly tell me what will be the value of x, v, and a. Okay, very good. So I'm having a mix of answers. Very good, all of you are correct. So if I put theta, what is the IDC? IDC means theta equal to 0. If I'm talking about the IDC position, your theta is equal to 0. That means if theta is equal to 0, that means x equal to 0, velocity equal to 0. Okay, and if I put theta equal to 0, you will be having omega square r into, if this is 0, this is 1 plus 1 by n. So those who are saying acceleration equal to 0, no, it won't be equal to 0. Now tell me about omega CR. What is the formula of omega CR? I'm writing for you guys so that you can have a idea. Omega CR is equal to omega cos theta by n, and omega and alpha CR. Yes, very good, all of you. Acceleration is equal to 0. Very good. Minus omega square sine theta by n. So this will be equal to omega by n will be equal to 0. All of you are correct. So if I say in the problem, if I'm talking about the inner dead center, then definitely we'll be having the angular velocity of the connecting rod will be equal to omega by n. The acceleration of the connecting rod will be equal to 0. So these type of question you can expect in the SSE JEE examination or IES objective paper. Definitely you can expect a question like this. They'll be saying, When the piston is at the bottom dead center, what is the angular velocity of crank connecting rod? Sir, crank ki analysis nahi hai. No, it's not required. Fine, because the main portion which we are doing is the connecting rod and crank, connecting rod and the piston. If it is required, definitely we'll be taking the crank analysis also, because we'll be doing the crank analysis in case of dynamic. Because in the dynamic, we'll be doing the crank analysis also. Okay, so don't worry, we'll be covering up that in that session. Abhishek Kushwa. Clear? So I suppose now you have understood the kinematic analysis of the single slider crank mechanism, about how the you can expect this. They are basically asking a one mark problem from these topics. Crank analysis, if it is required, definitely I can take that also. Don't worry. Okay. Fine. Repeat the question. The question was, let us suppose your piston is at, or the crank is at the bottom dead center, or the piston is at the bottom dead center. So in that case, you need to take theta equal to 180 degree. If theta equal to 180 degree, you can definitely calculate the rest of the parameter, that is x, v, a, omega cr and alpha cr. Okay. Kannada, Vivek, Abhishek, Vishnu, Sharachandran, Pavan. Fine. I hope so now you have understood. Okay, I hope so now you have understood. And in the next session, we'll be talking about the dynamic analysis, which is very important, because we'll be using this concept. The concept which you have studied in the today's session, we'll be using this concept in the dynamic analysis, and we'll be taking up the different forces. What are the different forces which are acting on the piston, on the connecting rod and the crankshaft or the crank? Okay, so don't worry, everything will be covered in this sessions. So this is it from my side. I suppose now it's clear. Now you have understood the kinematic analysis of the single, because normally none of the what is the next topic, sir? Next topic will be the dynamic analysis. Okay, dynamic analysis with the next topic, which we'll be covering in the tomorrow or the day after tomorrow session. Okay, don't worry, we'll be having a complete series of the theory of machine. Now now as this has ended, now let me talk about the Vision 2020 course which we are having, 2021 course which we are having for ESE and GATE. Okay, so the Vision 2021 course is for batch 2, because we have already the batch 1 seats are already full, so we have started batch 2. Same timing, 9 o'clock. Please mark your timing, 9 o'clock. I will be meeting you every day from Monday to Friday. We'll be meeting at 9 o'clock, so don't worry, just stay tuned with us. Sir, YouTube previous lectures are, yes, free series is going on. The previous lectures you can definitely see. There's a playlist of you can just directly search my name, or you can just directly search theory of machine playlist grade up. You'll be having a complete grade up, playlist. Okay, fine. And if I talk about the ongoing course, we are having a live evening classes. This is the key point, because the students who are doing job, or those who are school or the college going students, they won't be having time in the morning or the evening session. Okay, so that morning or afternoon. So we are planning for those students, so they can prepare for 1 year with the grade up. Live evening classes will be there, 750 plus quizzes. Okay, and the timing, I suppose you all know, it's from 7 to 9 and 9:30 to 11:30 p.m. Okay. Fine, and every day we'll be solving some quizzes, GATE level and ESE level, so that will improvise your understanding on that subject. So, and if I talk about the scholarship which we are providing to all the GATE qualified for 17, 18, 19 and 20, for IIT, NIT, Government, BTech students, for ESE prelims qualified also, we are giving 50% off. For more info, you just contact at this number, or you can drop a mail at help@gradeup, or you can contact Mr. Anand Pandey. He will be definitely helping you out. Just take say my name, he will be helping you out more frankly. Okay, fine. Thank you. This is it from my side, and I request all of you to be stay at home. Don't go outside. If there is a medical emergency, then only go outside, unless and until it's that much of emergency. Please don't step outside of your home. Okay, so thank you guys. This is Suraj Gopi signing off. So you need to prep smart, stay healthy, go grade up. Thank you. Bye bye and good night, and stay safe, healthy. Bye bye. Good night.